So here's our latest project. It's a John Deere 4010. Neighbor dropped it off last night because the engine is seized on it. So we're gonna diagnose what caused the seize and see if he wants to rebuild it or if he's gonna part it out. So that's what I'm working on now. I'm taking the oil pan off here. Gonna see if all the rods and journals are free. Hoping at least one of them is seized so it's easy fix, but we'll see once. So here we are. I managed to get the oil pan off. That's what it looks like underneath. And the oil pan. Here, as you see, that's all metal. There's like a big pile of metal right here. So definitely see something. So we're checking for play on the rods and stuff to make sure they're not seized, and the crankshaft looks all right. It's got play in it, and all of the rods have play in it except for this one up here, and it's stuck. So we're figuring we're gonna zip this one off. We're figuring this one's seized up, and that's probably the issue there. So here's the rods for that number two piston. It looks like this right here, it looks like these two spun and they got wedged and caused it to seize because the little lips that hold it in are gone. So that's the issue.
One crank.
There it goes.
That's cool.
Oh.
What, that's junk?
Mm-hmm. That's what news for.
What?
That's what new stuff is for.
Why you gotta whisper?
Because.
I can't hear you on the camera when you whisper.
That's why I whisper.
That's why you whisper? Oh. I didn't want it on me. So you just degreased it, cleaning it up. You like doing this? Did you hear that? Maybe they've been replaced recently. No, okay.
Hold on. Put it back together.
Where's that malt mallet that I bought? There's a certain way it goes on?
There's only one way it goes on.
Does that one only fit that side?
No.
Or can you put it on either?
I could put this one on the other.
Oh, what's that?
Plastic gauge.
Here, let me help you. See that? No.
Little.
Does it stay in there?
No. Oh. You gotta tighten it down, then you pop it back off and spec it out, see if the tolerance is right.
How many foot pounds?
100.
100?
So now we're loosening the bolts back up, pop the cap back off, make sure the plastic gauge is in spec.
Then what?
Looks like it's about 7.0017.
So that's in spec, so.
Okay.
You need to peel it off with your fingernails. Or for people that don't have fingernails, you do something else. I don't know what you would do.
Shine it all up, and then you gotta put it back together?
Yep. Put it back together, then it's done.
What are we looking for?
Timing.
They purchased a manual just for this, and he's got to figure out the timing. How to get the timing right.
Up your arms. Ready? Okay, you got a little thing to grab on. Is there no studs on this?
No.
Cool. What about inside that?
Not sure where that on this kind of insert.
Insert? Okay. Making sure.
Do you have anything to say?
Happy 4th of July.
Okay. Does that mean the video is going to be done at for the 4th of July?
Nope.
No. Thank you. The engine is ready to get put back into the tractor. Ethan has it all rebuilt, so the guys are gonna work today at putting it back in. And hopefully everything works properly.
Ready? I'm almost done. Go, go, go. Hey, I'm in. I think. Nope. Probably won't. Okay. You're started? Okay. I'm gonna put it down. I'm gonna drop it just a little bit.
That looks pretty close. Now it's just gonna go up.
But you gotta go up?
Yeah.
Oh! I just went to the trap.
You're just so strong. Steer it, Sanders.
Hey, why don't we leave it like this?
Yeah.
There we go.
Longest tractor ever made.
We can put two engines. Oh, wait. This is supposed to be in the thing.
Yeah.
All right. Now ahead. Roll. Stop. Stop. Okay. Oop. Head.
This thing's got
it. Ahead.
Pump's got to line up.
A little more. Whoa. Hold on.
Like I said.
This belt supposed to be in here?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Got a turn. They just hit.
Oh, I figured they slid in.
They didn't. No, they just bumped each other. Okay.
That doesn't seem very.
All right, where are we going ahead? Or more? Okay, which way? Up, down? Oh my
up,
God.
Down. Yeah, that'd be a bit long if it was.
I got top. Front's got to go up a little bit.
Now it doesn't seem as long.
Okay, we got it all together. Ethan put the injectors on, injection pump. So now we are going to manually check the oil pressure just to make sure it has oil before we start it. So right here by the injection pump is where the oil sending unit goes. So we got this gauge that we screwed in there. So we rolled it over a little bit already. So we're gonna roll it over and make sure when it's rolled over that it's supposed to be how many pounds?
25 to 35.
So there it is. We got 25 pounds of pressure.
So that's good. So Sydney's been working on the key. I think he's got it figured out because this is a 24 volt system, and we've never really worked on 24, so it's taken a little bit to get the head wrapped around, but I think he's got it figured out. So here we go. We're gonna see if it'll start. So so we got oil pressure, and I'm gonna hold the gauge, or we'll show the gauge.
That's the secret start.